Hello, everyone. I'm WDSU sports anchor Fletcher Mackel, and this is a special edition of the WDSU Hot Seat. Tonight, we are dedicating all things to the black and gold, specifically the 2021 New Orleans Saints draft. The rookie draft class this year features six players, three on defense, three on offense. They are Peyton Turner, a defensive end from Houston, Pete Werner, a linebacker from Ohio State, Paulson Adebo, a cornerback from Stanford, then offensively, Ian Book, a quarterback out of Notre Dame, Landon Young, an offensive tackle from Kentucky, and Kawan Baker, a wide receiver from South Alabama. Joining us now to do a deep dive into the Saints draft, our good friend, Mike Triplett from ESPN. Mike, your overall thoughts on the 2021 Saints draft?
Yeah, look, I understand the disappointment from a lot of Saints fans on Twitter because there was no buzz moves in this draft. There were no, first of all, there were no dynamic playmakers at wide receiver. There was no trade up when we had reports and the Saints acknowledging that they were trying to move all the way into the top 10. They never did that. They didn't feel like anybody that you're like, this guy is starting day one and we're so excited about him. And nobody that, you know, wow, every draft analyst I read had this guy going 15th and the Saints got him 28th. What a steal. There was none of that. But to pretend like I could give a grade and be like, well, I'm going to have to give them a D because, you know, they didn't get the guys. I'll tell you what I do know. At 28, they probably got someone who was in the top 20 on their board. At 60, they probably got somebody who was in the top 40 on their board. You know, 76, they traded up for a guy who was probably in their top 50 and so on and so forth. So it depends. Are we looking at, you know, my guys who I love, Mel Kiper and Todd McShay's rankings? Or are we looking at Mickey Loomis and Sean Payton and Jeff Ireland's ranking? Because I'm sure they nailed this draft according to their rankings. But one thing I found really funny was the people who didn't like the Peyton Turner pick, it was, yeah, sure, he's got the size and the athleticism and he looks great on tape. But he went to Houston. He didn't play great competition. There's not much experience there. Then they hate the Ian Book pick. Yeah, he went to Notre Dame and he played at the top level of the game with tons of experience and he went 30-5, but he doesn't have the size. And it's like, you know, you want both.
Mike, let's talk about quarterback Ian Book. You did a really great column last week on ESPN.com about NFL quarterbacks taken in rounds 2 through 7 outside of the first round. History isn't on Ian Book's side. What do you think of the selection of Ian Book out of Notre Dame, specifically in referencing the column that you wrote last week about these quarterbacks who are taken in the middle rounds?
Yeah, unfortunately, that research project I did last week points out how long, you know, the odds are for him, because there was a Russell Wilson and a Dak Prescott and obviously a Tom Brady and a Tony Romo. But the one thing we actually never see anymore in the NFL is drafting the guy, just like what we think the Saints might do with Ian Book. Drafting him, you don't have to start this year. We got Jameis Winston and Taysom Hill. We're going to teach you for a couple years. Maybe in year three, you become our starter. That never actually happens in the NFL, even though it sounds so good. Now, here's the difference. It could work with, you know, Sean Payton and the Saints organization. You know, if a quarterback's going to work somewhere, here's a place where it could work. So I'm not saying it can't happen, but it's extremely rare. So Book, you know, he's a long shot to eventually be an NFL starter. But I will say this, everything we're going to say about him being a long shot to be an NFL starter, they were saying when he was a lightly, you know, when he wasn't a five-star recruit that went to Notre Dame and he was the backup for 2 years who stepped in because of an injury. And he never gave that job up again. And 3 years later, he's won 30 games there.
Mike, on Saturday, I asked head coach Sean Payton, does Ian Book have a chance to come in and compete right away for the starting job to replace Drew Brees, competing with Jameis Winston and Taysom Hill? While Payton said they never want to put a ceiling on a player, that would be a big leap. Your thoughts on Book coming in maybe immediately in pushing these guys? Is that even possible for him to maybe be the starter sometime this season?
I agree. I mean, look, the Russell Wilson story, that was the year they signed a guy everybody knows around here, Matt Flynn, to a very big free agent contract. Because they needed a quarterback. They signed Matt Flynn to the big free agent contract. They draft Russell Wilson in round 3. And then you start hearing buzz, you know, Wilson could take over at some point. And then by week 1, he's the starter. So that's the rare dream scenario. But obviously the vision, the plan, the likelihood is not him really being in this competition from the get-go unless there's, you know, injuries or unexpected developments.
Mike, head coach Sean Payton said the team's biggest need heading into the draft was cornerback. They got one in the third round. Linebacker, we also knew, was a need. Wide receiver, defensive tackle, maybe help on the offensive line. How do you feel right now about the Saints? Is we are several months away from the start of training camp. Will they make moves in free agency? Where do you think they go from here?
Yeah, I think they could do that at corner and receiver, to be honest with you. I like their depth at receiver, but I don't know that they have that number two, number three guy, along with Michael Thomas and Tre'Quan Smith. But corner is the one. No, I do think they will continue to look at free agency. They have talked to Richard Sherman. I don't know how likely that is. I don't know if the fact that they drafted the corner in round three might make Sherman think, you know, you don't really need me, which is something he's indicated. He's waiting to find out a team that really needs a starter. He doesn't want to be competing or sitting behind a rookie. But there are a lot of talented veteran corners still out there. It's a position that really took a hit because of the reduced salary cap this year. Unfortunately, the Saints have like $0 to spend. I know we say that all the time with their cap, but every other year it's like, oh yeah, it says they have no cap space, but they've got ways to get it. This year they have like almost no ways to create cap space unless they get some extensions done with some current players. But there's probably room to squeeze in one more guy, and I think corner would be the position where they do that.
For the first time in 15 years, we are entering Saints life without Drew Brees. Are you cautiously optimistic because of the talent that this team still has? Cam Jordan, Michael Thomas, Alvin Kamara. I could go on and on and on. Or do you have more concern because the most important position is quarterback and it's kind of the great unknown right now?
Well, I would say this. I mean, look, there's not a lot of optimism that we're going to see the 2011 Saints this year, you know, where they had maybe the best quarterback play in NFL history, or, you know, that whole stretch from, you know, 08 to 14 or whatever you want to call it. But the 17 through 20 Saints did not rely on throwing the ball downfield, putting up preposterous 5,000 passing yards numbers. And this last year in particular, they actually had very uneven quarterback play. Drew Brees admitted himself that he was hurt all season. He did not look great early in the year. He broke his ribs and missed four games, and Taysom Hill was a starter. And then Drew Brees came back and he wasn't 100%. And that team went 12-4. So this isn't a team that you need your quarterback to be one of the three best quarterbacks in the NFL or you're not making the playoffs. That's a different Saints team. This is a Saints team that, you know, if you get above average quarterback play, you're probably an 11-12 win team. And I think they can get above average play. So I'm not saying, you know, I think I'm so excited for what they have at quarterback and they can't lose, but they're still going to have, you know, when we put out all these top 100 player in the NFL list, there's probably going to be eight Saints in the top 100. I mean, they still have all the guys you met, you know, both of their offensive tackles, Michael Thomas and Kamara and Cam Jordan and DeMario Davis and Marshawn Lattimore. This Marcus Williams, this team is loaded with talent. It can win with a run game. It can win because of its offensive line. It can win sometimes because of its defense. I think there's some long-term questions because some of the guys we just named are older or heading into the final years of their contract. I think they can still be really competitive this year.
Mike, final question here I have to ask. Aaron Rodgers and the Packers are feuding right now. Aaron Rodgers doesn't want to play for the Packers anymore. The Packers say they won't trade him. Could the Saints get into the Aaron Rodgers trade talks? Obviously, Russell Wilson was a hot name when he had a little rift earlier this year with Seattle. He stayed in Seattle. How does this unfold with Aaron Rodgers and the Packers? Could the Saints get involved in Aaron Rodgers quarterbacking the New Orleans Saints? Dream big, Who Dat Nation. I don't think it's a real possibility. What are your thoughts on that subject?
Well, look, my answer on Aaron Rodgers is the same as it was with Russell Wilson. And even when, you know, Deshaun Watson seemed like he might be in play earlier in the offseason, is the Saints should want him. The Saints would probably have conversations about how could we fit him? What would it take? What salary moves would we have to make? And what would we have to trade the Packers? But if he's really going somewhere, it's hard to imagine the Saints can make the best offer. They don't have high draft picks to offer, especially not if Aaron Rodgers becomes their quarterback. They might be picking in the 30s next year. They, you know, don't have, you know, the California location that some people think he might want. So I think it might be hard for them to be the highest bidder, but of course they should be interested.
All right, Mike Triplett, ESPN, tremendous insight and analysis as always. And that's the WDSU Hot Seat. Reporting from my home, I'm Fletcher Mackel, WDSU News.